T-Curve Memorial, paying $4,000 a win, 40-lapper for the Neesmith Chevrolet Dirt Late Models. We're coming to green out of turn number four. How many of you are ready to go racing here at the High Banks of Volunteer Speedway? It's Chris Rick and Michael Woods. Here we go. They'll race into turn number one down the back straightaway. Rick, get up the hill, they bang. In turn number two down the back straightaway, and the Silver Bullet will take the lead. Michael Woods will run second. Now here comes Brett the Jet Miller to the inside of Wayne Rader, and he'll take over the third spot and look for second on Michael Woods in turn one. They'll travel down the back straightaway. Austin Atkins trying to charge his way up through the top five. Jeffrey Milton six. Seventh is Robbie Buchanan, who's got problems in P21. He's off the pace in turn number three. He'll make it to the infield and will stay green. Two laps on the board. Now Brett Miller will pull a slide job in turn number one and two, and he'll take over the second spot from Michael Woods. Down the back straightaway through turns four. After three laps, it is still the Silver Bullet. Chris Rickett is leading. Brett Miller running him down in a hurry in the Bill and Sue Curl Motorsports entry out of Knoxville, Tennessee, and he is coming in a hurry. That race car up for sale, $12,500. We'll take the race car, all the parts, motor, transmission, and the trailer. Great deal for a fast race car if you want to get into racing. We got a smoker out of turn number four. It's Chuck Killian, but we should stay green. As five are in the books, 15 laps to go. Down the back straightaway, Brett Miller still trying to work over Chris Rickett for the lead. Michael Woods sitting in third in 66 with a good effort, but he is facing pressure from Perrinsville, Tennessee's Wayne Rader. Side by side for third into turn number one they go. Down the back straightaway, Austin Atkins holding down the fifth spot. Jeffrey Milton is sixth as the leaders working over lap traffic. By Jeffrey Milton, it might have cost Chris Rickett just a little bit of time, and here comes the Jet. Into turn number one, they'll race down the back straightaway. It'll be Brett Banks, the next car to go a lap down as the leaders. Third, fourth, and fifth place worked by the lapper of Chuck Killian. Both the leaders clear. Brett Bank out of turn number four, and now Brett Miller looks for the lead down the front straightaway. Good race here in the modified street. Chris Rickett trying to hold him off down the back straightaway, but Brett Miller turning laps quicker than the 36 of Chris Rickett as they come out of turn number four. Now Wayne Rader's going to have contact with the third place car. They get together out of four. It's going to cost them real estate. Austin Atkins to the podium spot in turn number one and two. So contact with the third and fourth place car shuffles them both back two spots. And we keep racing down the front straightaway as we are halfway. Cross flags, 10 in the books, 10 laps to go. Down the back straightaway, Chris Rickett works into turn three. We got problems in turn two. Caution is out. Caution is out. We're going to come to green out of turn number four. We are halfway done in this one. 10 are in the books, and we've got 10 laps to go. And the Silver Bullet mashes the loud pedal. We're backing away as Jeffrey Milton may have problems on the four car. He's already lost two spots. Big smoke coming out of Tracy Wolf's 11 car. That could be a big hit in points as Jeffrey Milton continues to fall. Positions down the back straightaway, and he's got problems. He's off the pace. Tracy Wolf may realize he's got some smoking issues under the 11 car as we continue. And Jeffrey Milton is pulled to the infield. He may have a flat tire on the four car. As we keep racing, Brett Miller now starting to challenge again for the lead. Austin Atkins right behind him in 14 down the back straightaway. Brett Miller with a big run out of turn number two. He couldn't make it anything. And they stay with Chris Rickett, the leader, down the front straightaway. They'll try it again. A Baker's dozen are complete here tonight. 13 in the books. With seven laps to go as Tracy Wolf gets the black flag at the start-finish line. Brett Miller continuing to put pressure on Chris Rickett. Can he get it done tonight? The Silver Bullet's been tough all year long, but Brett Miller in the Bill and Sue Curl Motorsports entry. Rickett's got problems down the back straightaway. Are you kidding? Oh, my goodness. Caution is out. $12,500 will put you in the seat of that race car. And it looks pretty good here tonight. Out front leading with Brett Miller in the pilot seat, back to green with a half a dozen circuits left. Down the back straightaway they'll go. Austin Ack is going to try to find a way to get around the 47. Good battle now for third as Wayne Rader will look to the bottom side of the 66 of Michael Woods to battle for third. And now it's five circuits left, just a handful of laps for Brett Miller. Down the back straightaway they travel. 14 car. Austin Atkins has had some bad luck this year. He's had a flip at one particular incident down at 411 Motor Speedway. He's had several mechanical failures, but got it all going on here tonight with a solid second place run. Got him a win just last week at Tazewell Speedway, trying to follow it up here tonight at the gap, but he's got to get around Brett Miller to do it with just three laps to go. We've got a good one through one and two. Down the back straightaway, White Pine, Tennessee's Michael Woods still having a good run with the Jerry Hux Motorsports entry of Wayne Rader running fourth. Now Shannon Emery makes a challenge on the Godfather out of turn number four, and he'll take over the fifth spot. Two laps to go this time out of turn number four. We'll see the white flag from veteran chief starter Terry Gillingwater side by side for the lead at the line. One lap to go. Austin Atkins going for the lead. Little smoke out of the 47. Final time around down the back straightaway. Can Austin Atkins do anything down in turns three and four as they'll bring him to the checker down the front straightaway? They're going to touch at the line. Down in turns three and four as they'll bring them to the checker down the front straightaway. They're going to touch at the line. What a race to kick off. The Freedom is in free 50 here tonight at Volunteer Speedway. The 47 is going to go to victory. The 23 car, GM Power Warrior out of Evans, Georgia, looking for two in a row here tonight. It is Anna Parkhurst. Jimmy Elliott in J39 out of Cleveland, Tennessee, alongside of Knoxville, Tennessee's John Blankenship in 56. Then it'll be Jason Manley at Loudoun, Tennessee, alongside of Cameron Skinner at Knoxville. Vic Chandler, Preston Whitehead, Adam Tolliver, Dennis Stiles, they'll all bring us to green at a turn number four. We are underway. Contact at the start between the leaders. They make it into turn number one. It will stay green down the back straightaway. Corey Hedgecock will take the blunt of it as they're three wide for second. Problems down the back straightaway. It's going to be big. Oh, it's a hard hit into the infield wall. A terrible crash down the back straightaway. Somebody has hit the infield wall hard. It's the Dirty White Boy. He won Friday at Crossville 2000. Picked up another 2000 in the Steelhead feature last night at Wartburg. He's looking for 1,500 more here tonight. And here we go at a turn number four. Better start that time down into turn number one down the back straightaway. Corey Hedgecock gets a pretty good run off the top side as Ross White looks to the bottom. And now Hedgecock will battle to the inside of the Dirty White Boy for the lead down the front straightaway. Anthony White will lead lap one. They battle back into turn number one and two. Now Rusty Ballinger with a good fight through one and two down the back straightaway. They're side by side for the fourth spot. 29 car, Rusty Ballinger will slide in front of Tim Bird, and he'll take fourth down the front straightaway. And now Bird rallies back to the outside. Good tussle right there. Four cars, you can throw a blanket over them with Ballinger, Bird, Thompson, and the 24 car of Greg Martin. All those 24s battling hard as they come down the front straightaway. They were nearly three wide for sixth spot. Down the back straightaway, Jordan Horton working the top side of the speedway, but your two leaders are checking out on the field as the caution is going to come out. To slow us down, bring the caution out. Photographer Todd Renario, the official 2017 photographer at Volunteer Speedway and 411 Motor Speedway from NVS Photography, will go out and pick that debris up. As the Dirty White Boy will mash the loud pedal out of turn number four, he'll bring us back to green. Ross White with a good charge to the outside in turn number one and two. Down the back straightaway, can't get it done, and here comes Tim Bird out of nowhere. Greg Martin has problems getting through one and two. Tim Bird's up to fourth, and now side by side for Ross White for third. Rusty Ballinger's going to lose spots. Phillip Thompson with a good run. They're three wide for fifth down the back straightaway. Rusty Ballinger with problems. He's going to lose a couple of spots, and now Jimmy Elliott is off the pace down the back straightaway. Five laps in the books. A quarter left, 25 laps to go for the Dirty White Boy. Anthony White starting to sail away around the high banks of the Volunteer Speedway, but Corey Hedgecock back to the bottom of three and four, starting to run him down. Through one and two, they go down the back straightaway. Ross White with a solid third in his zero car here tonight. Greg Martin way up the hill in turn two. He'll lose a spot to Phillip Thompson, who moves up to sixth. Now Corey Hedgecock, heavy pressure for the lead in turn number one and two. Down the back straightaway they go. Hitchcock looked at the bottom of Anthony White, could not get there. Side-by-side battle for the fourth spot as Jordan Horton is starting to work his way to the front. He'll throw an elbow on the 24 of Tim Bird, and he'll move to fourth. Side-by-side at a turn number two down the back straightaway for the lead. Corey Hitchcock had to give a little bit as they start to catch lap cars of Jason Milton and Dennis Stiles down the front straightaway. Corey Hitchcock starting to make this a two-horse race. Lap cars down the back straightaway. They're going to split them. Look out. Into turn number three and four. Anthony White got trapped, but so did Corey Hitchcock. They're going to be side-by-side for the lead down the front straightaway. What a race. Second feature of the night, and it's a good one as well down the back straightaway as Corey Hitchcock is starting to battle with Anthony White, getting racy into turns number three and four. Off the bottom of four down the front straightaway. 11 laps in the books. Down the back straightaway they go again. Corey Hedgecock's got the 23 car dialed in on the bottom. Anthony White likes the top as they go by the G2 of Knoxville, Tennessee's Jerry Green. A dozen scored here with 18 to go. Ross White is starting to slip back in the grips of the 57 of Jordan Horton as they battle towards turn number three. Corey Hedgecock continues to take looks to the inside. In one and two and three and four down the front straightaway, they get together. Look out, the leaders have crashed. Trouble down the back straightaway, the leaders have crashed. Out of turn number four, Ross White mashes the loud pedal. We are underway. Ross White leads them back into turn number one and two. Good restart for Tim Burt down the back straightaway. He's taking over second. Jordan Horton will quickly go back to the bottom and look for the runner-up spot back. Out of turn number four and down to the stripe. Now Todd Morrow is taking over the fourth spot. Been running with the Southern All-Stars the last couple of years. Having a good run here tonight. He'll look for the podium spot to go to third. We got problems out of turn number two. Multiple cars have gotten together. Gary Crittenden is one of them over there. John Blankenship involved as well in 56. Out of turn number four, Ross White looking for a big win here tonight. He'll mash the loud pedal and we're back underway. Jordan Horton going to battle with the 24, Tim Bird through turns one and two, and he'll have second. They get together. Are you kidding? Down the back straightaway. And your second and third place cars have tangled down the back straightaway, and Jordan Horton is not happy. Horton with a good run to the outside out of turn number two. At the green out of turn number four to be Ross White and Zero who fires, and we're back underway. Tempers flaring here tonight at the gap. Todd Morrow looks to the inside of Ross White down the back straightaway. Greg Martin up the hill. And here comes Rusty Ballinger for fourth. Three wide the back of the pack. It's Anna Parkhurst making moves through the middle. Down back into turn number one. They'll race down the back straightaway. Rusty Ballinger's got fourth. Greg Martin settles into fifth. Tim Maupin in sixth. And now Josh Henry's made it to seventh. Phillip Thompson up to third now as Barrett's got problems on his zero machine. And he'll go to the infield. They race down the back straightaway, all kinds of mind problems. Greg Martin has got all kinds of problems. He pushes up the hill again in one and two, and it may cost him the sixth spot. It will from Josh Henry out of turn number four. Ross White around the bottom of the racetrack, so is Todd Morrow as they go down the back straightaway. Problems for John Blankenship in turn two, and the caution will have to come out. G2 of Todd Morrow. If he's got anything left for Ross White, he's got to lay it on the line now at a turn number four, now on the front straightaway. Rusty Ballinger trying to work on the third spot, and here comes Corey Hitchcock through turn number one. He's made it up to seventh, side-by-side with Jason Manley now as they race into turns three and four. Now it's going to be six laps to go, half a dozen left in this one as they race down the back straightaway. It's Ross White with Todd Morrow in second. Third is Phillip Thompson. Fourth, the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. And Tim Maupin ramps out the top five in the three car. Back down the back straightaway they race with 20 laps in the books. Five laps to go for Ross White if he can hold on. But Todd Morrow is staying right with him in the D2. Todd Morrow trying to get a run for the lead down the back straightaway. Just hasn't been able to get there so far. don't believe lap traffic will be an issue. We should get all the way in this one. Corey Hedgecock still trying to work towards the front as he's made it up to seventh, and he looks to the inside of Josh Henry in turn number one. And that would move him up to sixth if he can get by as they work out of turns number three and four with just two circuits left. Down the back straightaway. And out of turn number four, they will take the white flag. One lap to go. Final time around. It'll be the RT Clap Professional Car Care Select Insurance Hoosier Tire South Bruce Peel Performance Phantom Powered Rocket for Ross White to take the win. Second will go to the D2 of Todd Morrow. Third to Philip Thompson. Fourth to Rusty Ballinger. And fifth to Tim Maupin. So the leaders will run out of turn number four into the infield. Tim Maupin brings the three car home tonight in the fifth spot. Fourth will go to the 29 of Rusty Ballinger. Third to the third to the 24 of Philip Thompson. Second to the D2 of Todd Morrow. And your winner tonight in car number zero. Out of Knoxville, Tennessee, the RT Clap Professional Car Care Select Insurance Hoosier Tire South Bruce Built Performance Phantom Race Engines Powered Bruce Built Rocket, former Volunteer Racing Series Rookie of the Year. How about it for Knoxville, Tennessee's Ross White?